after that, this algorithm, first tool is, we have discussed about the algorithm as problem solving tool, and the another problem solving tool is flowchart. In algorithm, what we did, we have written all the steps to develop or to solve a particular problem. To solve a particular problem, we have written all the steps. But in contrast to algorithm, in flowchart, what we do, we pictorially represent the solution of a problem. Okay, so you know, a picture is much more powerful as comparison to 1,000 words. Okay, so you can say a picture speaks louder than words. So in the flowchart is basically the pictorial representation of all the steps involved in solving a particular problem. Flowchart as comparison to algorithm are easier to understand as it depicts the problem graphically. So you can see here, you can see we have given these steps here, and you can see a solution of a particular problem. This is the solution of sum of two numbers. The problem is, we want to get the sum of two numbers, and how to draw a flowchart we will understand later in the next slide. First of all, we will learn what are the various advantages of this drawing a flowchart. So first of all, improved communication, because it is graphically represented, so it is easily communicated to other people. Okay, visual clarity, again the things are graphically represented, so visually it's appear clearly. Okay, after that, effective analysis, drawing with the help of drawing structure. If someone is saying to you to build a house, there may be two things: either he will describe everything on the paper, or he will give a layout of your home in the form of drawing on paper. What will be more effective? Of course, that drawing will be more effective for you. So effective analysis can be done. What may be the drawbacks can be pointed out easily. Okay, and the customers or the person who are involved in the software development can easily understand what is going through the whole process. Problem solving, the same point he is discussing. The problem can be resolved with the help of flowcharts and the documentation. Actually, any of the tool, either it may be flowchart, or it may be algorithm, or pseudocode, everything is a type of documentation that how the software has been developed or the program is developed. Okay, now the next thing is, what are the various diagrammatically structures or diagrammatic elements that is used to draw a flowchart? To draw a flowchart, basically there are few symbols we used, and first one is the start and stop symbol. This is a symbol you can see here. It's a symbol that you can use for terminal symbol, you can call it, or the start stop symbol, because it is used to draw the start position or the stop position. Start position or stop position. So yeah, start and stop. So that's why these are known as terminal symbol. Next is the input output symbol. Input output symbol is basically used to display output and to get input from the user. Third one is the process symbol, a rectangle shape hota hai. It's a rectangular shape, and then it is used for processing. Okay, so processing is used here. And the decision symbol is basically used to put certain condition in a loop. I put certain condition in a flowchart, so you can use the decision symbol also. Flow line is basically used to draw the flow of program. Okay, a flow of the program, it will depict to show the flow of program. And the connector, when your program is too large, so to connect two geographically located sections of a program, we use connector. Okay, suppose this program is this flowchart is, some part of this flowchart is here and remaining portion is on the another slide, so we can put a connector here. We will put a connector here, and again this connector will start on this. So we can write again our program from here. So stop will not be here. Instead of stop, A will be here, and this connector will start again here. So it depicts that this is the flow chart which is continuing on the next page. Is it clear? Okay. Now this is a small algorithm to find the average of three numbers. So first of all, what we need to acquire algorithm, we have to understand what are the input, what are the processes, and what is the output. The input, of course, we need to get the average of three numbers. To do this, first of all, we need three numbers. So the input will be these three numbers whose average is required. After that, we need to do processes. First thing is to get the sum of these three numbers, or the given three numbers, and then divide the given sum total with three. So in this way you will get the average. Okay, after that you will display that average. So here now the same thing we are doing with the help of flowchart. So start and then input n1 n2 n3. What are these n1 n2 n3? These are the three numbers which user will provide. After that you need to do summation of these three numbers. Sum is equal to n1 plus n2 plus n3. So these three numbers are added together and assigned to a variable called sum. After that, we will divide the sum value by 3, because the total inputted numbers are 3. So we will divide it by 3, and average is equal to sum upon 3. After that, getting the average, you will print this average and you will terminate your program by giving stop. So in this way you can develop a flowchart for any kind of problem. Either you can develop algorithm, or you can develop flowchart. Next is, another problem is to draw a flowchart to find out inputted numbers is positive or not. Now in this flowchart, we have discussed about the decision box. In earlier chart, we have not applied decision box. You can see this decision box not applied here because it is not required in this case. But in the next case, we require a decision statement because we need to check whether the number is positive or negative. How will you check that? When a number is positive? Of course, when the number will be positive if it is greater than 0. So we will check this condition that number is positive or not. So first of all, we will start the program, then we will take a number which is required to check. After that, we will check num is greater than 0. There may be two situations: either num will be greater than 0 or it will be less than 0. If it is greater than 0, it means it's a positive number. So print the message, it is positive number. Otherwise, print number is negative. Okay, you can see the flow line here. Either in yes case, it is coming here. In no case, it is going here. In any case, only one set of operation will take part. One set of operation will be done. Either this set of operation will be done, or this set of operation will be done. okay? So it totally depends on condition. Whatever condition you have applied here, on this condition it is depend that which section of the code will execute. Either this section of the code will be executed or this section of code. Okay, after that this is going to end, and here also it is going to end. So in this way you can develop flowchart for any application. Now we will go to the exercise portion. Now tell me, or you can comment your answers in the comment box given here. You can go through the exercise, you can go through the slides, you will find the answers of these questions and given the answers in the comment section. Thank you so much. Meet you in the next meeting.